Blackstone Audio presents The Polygamist's Daughter, a memoir by Anna LeBaron with Leslie Wilson. This book is read by Anna LeBaron. Note from the author. This memoir was written from memory, with many details corroborated by close family members. Some names have been changed for the privacy of the individuals. Some scenes have been recreated to the best of my ability, and some of the events described have been compressed for brevity. Various details not known to me at the time of the events have been added to the story to give context to the reader. Except in certain circumstances, when the words were seared in my mind, the dialogue is not verbatim. It is, however, in keeping with the spirit of the events surrounding them. The same is true of the people. I describe them to the best of my recollection, based on my age at the time these events occurred, our circumstances and experiences, and my impressions of them at the time. I also want to make it clear that my father took the basic tenets of Joseph Smith's teachings, including polygamy, that had been practiced for generations in my family, and radically twisted them. My father promoted an extremism that shattered so many lives. The modern-day LDS Mormon Church officially disavowed polygamy in 1890. Within these pages, I tell my story. I hope one day the others involved will tell their own. Prologue. At age 9, I had 49 siblings. I didn't play hopscotch with my school friends at recess, or watch The Brady Bunch on television with my siblings. My mother didn't pack my school lunch, and my dad didn't give me a hug at the door, wishing me a good day. Instead, my parents, who were on the run from federal authorities, abandoned me in Mexico for about a year, leaving me with a family I didn't know, a family that included a man named Rafael. I was fed each day and had a foam pad to sleep on at night. But I found it difficult to sleep in this strange place, so far from my mom. Why couldn't I stay with her and the rest of my family in the United States, instead of in this dingy, dusty apartment south of the border? Even though I had grown up in polygamy, I had no idea of the truth. I was auditioning as a potential wife for Rafael. My father, the notorious Ervil LeBaron, had promised Rafael several of his daughters in marriage. If Rafael, a recent convert to my father's polygamous sect, was still in favor with him when we girls reached marriageable age, typically 15, it would happen. My sisters and I were pawns to be auctioned off to the highest bidder, those followers willing to do whatever my father asked, no matter what it involved. I understood from watching my mom, along with her 12 sister wives and my countless siblings, that no one was allowed to question my father's authority. So, like the others, I obeyed. And even though this life made my stomach ache, I never said a word. 1. What will we do without you? I stood in the driveway of our Dallas home, clinging to my mother as the sun rose higher in the sky, and begged her through my tears not to go. I couldn't imagine life without my mother. So great was my grief that I barely noticed her two sister wives saying goodbye to their own children. We had been living there only a short time, having moved yet again on short notice. I'd be sent off to school that day with no explanation as to why my mom had to leave again. Usually, she left without notice and would come back in a few days, or sometimes weeks. This time was different. She didn't know when she would be back. I'm sure Mom felt like she had no other choice. She was obeying my father's order. Ervil LeBaron led the Church of the Lamb of God, a radical offshoot of the Mormon Church. And Anna Mae was the fourth of his 13 wives. Like the other wives, she learned early on to do as she was told. My mom, raised in Arizona, had met and married her second husband, Nephi, when they were both part of the traditional Mormon church, known as the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Nephi attended one of Ervil LeBaron's exhaustive talks and eventually bought into my dad's more radical offshoot of Mormonism. He hurried home to tell my mom the way they'd been living out Joseph Smith's teaching was all wrong. When she remonstrated, Nephi invited Ervil to their home to convince my mom that they needed to convert and follow this new prophet. Ervil was powerfully persuasive, so much so that Nephi and my mother not only converted, but agreed to relocate to Colonia LeBaron in Chihuahua, Mexico. Nephi stayed in Arizona to sell their home, but my mom went ahead with their five children. During this transition, she spent an inordinate amount of time with Ervil, who, while tall, handsome, and charismatic, was also narcissistic, entitled, and manipulative. He proclaimed that he had a revelation that it was God's will and plan for my mom's life that she leave Nephi and marry him instead. She fell madly in love with Ervil, and like the other sister wives before and after her, she succumbed to his potent influence. They married, and she had seven more children with him, including me. "Please, Mom, don't go." On the driveway, I wrapped my arms around my mom's waist, my tears dampening the front of her faded denim dress.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.